I recently acquired a new desk. The problem is that my mouse doesn't work on it, as it's made of glass. I've been using an old mouse pad for a while now, but I hate the thing. Weirdly, these things haven't really changed since the 90s. They're quite ugly, they don't last, and they're soft as they were made for ball mice. So we need something new. A durable, flat surface. I want it to be hard so the mouse can glide more easily. Having a large surface would also be nice as it would promote motion from the whole arm, not just the wrist. The surface should also be wider to represent our new widescreens. Lastly, it should look good and be fairly cheap. So I figured, why not give concrete a try? To make this, you'll need some cement sand mix. Cement is like the glue in concrete. Sand acts as this filler and also gives it strength. Typically, concrete also has rocks, called aggregates, of varying size, but we won't be needing these as we'll be making a very thin sheet. You'll also need some kind of dye. I'm using black clothing dye, but you can also get specialized concrete dyes. I also suggest gloves, as it can get quite messy. You'll also need a mold. I'll be using an old cereal box. First, we'll mix the dye with boiling water in the proportions on the package. We won't need the salt. Do this in advance so the water isn't too hot when you're making the concrete. Next, we'll prepare our mold. I'm using a cereal box as it's about the size and proportions I wanted. I lined mine with wax paper, but I don't really recommend it as I was getting really messy corners because of it. You'll be fine if some water seeps into cardboard. I decided to add some nylon fibers to my concrete mix to give it a bit more strength. Feel free to try some various inlays. Finally, we'll roughly measure our cement mix. I had a mixing chart on the side of my bag, so that gave me a starting point. But you really want more than you need because it can be kind of deceiving how much you'll actually need in your project. We'll add our fibers at this time before the water. When mixing in the water, you want to go very slowly, as you want to properly mix it into the concrete, and also, it's a very, very fine balance between too dry concrete and too wet concrete. I also found mixing with my hands a bit easier. We can now pour our concrete into our mold. I put my mold on top of a ceramic tile to make sure the bottom was very flat. The key when pouring is to make sure there's as little air bubbles as possible, and also to fill out every possible crevice. Finally, we want to remove as much air as possible. You can shake around your concrete to help, but you can also poke it with a little stick. At this point, you can also use a straight tool to level the top, but I didn't find this necessary as our working surface will be the bottom one. I waited a day before removing the concrete from the mold, and 2 more days before it was dry to the touch. In hindsight, I would advise polishing the surface when the concrete is still a little damp as it's not as hard. I also decided to make a pedestal for my graphic tablet pen. I made the mold for this using part of a milk carton. I then sprayed some oil for easier removal. In the end, the mouse pad was almost usable. It had a nice polished finish on which the mouse could glide quite easily. However, it had some small bumps in it, so the mouse would sometimes get stuck. I tried removing these bumps using various grains of sandpaper. My idea was to start with very large grit and then work my way back to a polish. However, concrete's very hard. Even 100 grit sandpaper wasn't really enough to remove any kind of material. I stepped my game up. I grabbed my angle grinder, but my attachment was a bit too fierce. I was removing too much material, and I was creating even more bumps. Sadly, I hadn't properly attached the mouse pad to my workbench. So when I removed the clamp, the mouse pad broke. The pedestal also ended up breaking when I tried sanding it. I think this is due to the fact that the water I used for the concrete in it was a bit older and some of the water had evaporated, so it was more concentrated in dye. I don't think the adhesion was as good. So I'm not sure how usable a concrete mouse pad might really be. In the meantime, I've been using a ceramic tile as my mouse pad, and that's been working great. Now that I have a bunch of concrete left, I just might try some projects later on. I'll catch you guys later.